I'm Bryce Lowery, Assistant Professor of Regional and City Planning at the University of Oklahoma College of Architecture. In this video, I'll be discussing adaptation planning as it pertains to urban and regional development. Adaptation planning is increasingly associated with efforts to design, build, and maintain human communities. This is particularly true given recent weather extremes and natural disasters. On one hand, humanity will have to adapt to some anticipated changes in our way of life as flooding and drought occur more often. But on the other hand, the consequences of these events, such as destruction of homes, disruptions in food production, and the loss of power or water supply, may necessitate steps that mitigate these impacts at a faster rate than communities are used to. Adaptation and mitigation go hand in hand to allow us to address these local to global changes. Adaptation refers to the fit of an organism to its environment. It may focus on the short-term processes of how an organism survives, as well as the physical changes that result from long-term exposure to a particular environment. Adaptation may occur in three ways: behavioral, structural, and physiological. First, let's discuss behavioral changes. Organisms confronted with a change in their environment are likely to modify their behavior to adapt to pressures associated with the change. For example, species facing a food shortage may reduce activity in the short term to build reserves and wait out the loss of nutrients. Over the long term, these same organisms may need to find other sources of food in new territories if the previous source becomes scarce. Humans are no exception. For nomadic people, settlement was frequently associated with good agricultural land. Over time, as populations grew, it was often necessary to move to new fertile land. Today, cities and communities continue to adapt our behavior to the environment. For example, communities may implement recycling programs to reduce the growth of a nearby landfill, install green space in urban settings to address health concerns, or promote energy-saving measures to cope with collective demand for air conditioning on particularly hot days. Organisms may also undergo structural changes to adapt to their environment. They may transform physically to continue to thrive. These kinds of changes are often observed over long periods of time and may go unnoticed over shorter time frames. For instance, evidence suggests that the human appendix was extremely important for eating largely plant-based diet. However, as we became more adept at hunting, it is theorized that our appendix shrank. Today, we don't even need it. Looking at human communities, we see similar physical changes taking place. In some places, the model of human settlement is being reorganized to reduce the impact of environmental changes on communities. Such adaptations may include prohibiting development in flood zones, reorganizing cities that are shrinking as a result of population decline, or increasing population density to promote walkability and reduce reliance on private automobiles. Finally, organisms may undergo physiological change to adapt to the environment. Organisms rely on both physical parts, such as the lungs, as well as processes such as respiration to live. As the environment around us changes, humans will likely experience internal changes in the way the body works in order to survive. Human settlements can be viewed similarly as a set of interacting mechanisms that work collectively to support life. From this perspective, the metabolism of cities and towns is comprised of a set of inputs and outputs that interact to provide individuals with the resources necessary to support life. The systems that supply water, food, and energy, as well as those that dispose of solid and liquid waste, are central to this perspective. For human communities, adaptation at this level will likely involve an increasing reliance on locally available resources, as well as a reduction and reuse of waste materials in ways that lessen the potential for environmental change to disrupt these systems. Adaptation is not necessarily an automatic process, as shown by the numerous extinct species and depopulating cities. It can be difficult to achieve at both the individual and collective level. In some cases, individuals and communities can be slow to react to fluctuations in environment, as shown by the increasing incidence of environmental-related diseases and the growing reliance on disaster management planning and coordination seen in recent decades. Over time, we may adapt to increasing levels of pollution, flooding, and temperature fluctuation, but in the meantime, we may need to find technologies or policies that help us maintain a particular quality of life. We accomplish this through mitigation, the process of reducing the impact or consequences of environmental and ecological change through interventions such as levees, storm shelters, and artificial lakes. The future is certainly going to challenge regions, neighborhoods, and residents to adapt to a wide range of environmental changes. Adaptation planning will require the engagement of local residents in discussions about their vulnerability to natural and human-induced disasters. It also requires focused attention on encouraging residents to understand and adjust their current ways of living to potentially new and innovative ways of organizing human settlement. Professionals trained to help communities plan and manage for these challenges will need to help residents understand how adaptive strategies and mitigation techniques can be harnessed to overcome these challenges.